I'm Burç. I'm the CEO of Prisync. This is the fifth session of our e-commerce pricing training program, and today we will talk about cost plus pricing strategy. Cost plus pricing is a strategy where you set a price by calculating your costs and adding a markup. It's pretty easy to implement, but not without quite a few downfalls. So let's dive into its advantages and disadvantages. Like I said, it's perhaps the easiest way to price a product, but since there's no pain, there's not much gain in using this strategy, especially in competitive markets. Think about it. It's a strategy that relies on merely two factors, your cost and desired profit margin. What's the problem in keeping it simple, you might wonder? The problem is, with cost plus pricing strategy in play, you're ignoring crucial factors like competition, seasonality, market trends, the list goes on. And there are several consequences. First, since you're not monitoring your competition, it's almost guaranteed that you're pricing too low or too high. In the first case, you are leaving too much money on the table. In the latter, you are missing out on sales opportunities. Second, you stick with the same pricing plan for too long when everything else is in flux. Let's say one of your best sellers has a brand new alternative and it's cheaper. A lot of businesses use penetration pricing when entering a new market. They basically set a below average price to capture a large audience from early on. Now, it's likely that some of your customers will shift to them. To keep them from fleeing, you could take some measures like offering discounts, at least to your repeat buyers, right? But unfortunately, cost plus pricing doesn't give you that flexibility. With zero flexibility in pricing, it's almost impossible to adapt to the changing market conditions. Third, fixating on your costs doesn't help you emphasize the value you offer. Take the smartwatch market. Fitbit is, hands down, one of the dominant players, and they are more expensive than most alternatives. Why are they able to charge a lot more than alternatives? Not because their production costs are drastically higher. It's because they nailed branding. If you want to stay relevant in the future, you have to build a powerful brand that people trust, want to shop with, and advocate for. Doing this will increase people's willingness to pay for your products. So instead of focusing on your costs and the fixed profit margin, try better communicating your value proposition, adding value, and building a strong brand in the long run. So what? Are we suggesting you shouldn't factor in your costs when setting a price like at any stage? No, not at all. In the harshly competitive e-commerce market, the price competition sometimes turns into a price war. You really have to be careful not to sell below cost, unless it's your intention and you can make up for the loss. So, instead of relying solely on cost plus pricing, take your cost as just one factor when pricing your products. Alright everyone, this is all from us for now. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next video. Take care.